Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how you can add some dynamic properties to your components to make them randomly rotate on click. All right, so I modeled this treasure chest and I put in all these little coins, and then they were all the same because they were in the same direction. And so I thought, hey, it'd be really cool to use a dynamic component to then be able to click on these and get a random rotation so that it adds a little bit of variety in here instead of going through and manually rotating each coin. So what I did is I made this a dynamic component. And so in the top right here, you can see I have this toolbar docked. If you right click in a open area in your toolbar and just you want to find where it says dynamic components and just make sure that's checked. When it's checked originally, it'll show a little window, and then you can just drag that into an open area and that will dock that into your toolbar. So what we're going to be using today, interact with dynamic components. This little hand here is what we use to start to interact on click. And then what we're going to be using is component attributes, because that's where all the magic happens. That's down here. And what you can see here, just to talk about what is going on, by default, there's some rotation in here that I have brought in that just shows where the rotation is. Here is my command for on click. And then I have these custom parameters, ran X, ran Y, and ran Z. So basically an overview of what happens here is that on click, I set ran X, ran Y, and ran Z to a random number between, I changed it a little bit because originally I had from 0 to 360, that being the amount of degrees in a circle for all of these. But what I realized is that I kind of wanted these coins to lay flat. I didn't actually want it to be 360 because I don't want a vertical coin. So I messed around with some of the angles as I was going through and doing this and changed some of them. I figured Z, which is the blue, and a good way to just sort of think about this as you go through is just like, as you can see, these are color coded. So when you're in your component, you just want to make sure use your Q to enable the rotate tool and just check and make sure that the angles that you're using are what you want. And you can use the colors to sort of, to guide you through that. So what I've done here is I've gone through and I've taken my coin and I've removed all of the attributes from it so that we can really dive into this together. So when you click on your, you want to click on your object, make sure that you have component attributes brought up, and then it'll show you this little window. This is called a sketch link. So, and then it's made of two components, which you see nested underneath. They're both halves, they're flipped from each other. But we won't need to really mess with these in the model. We're just going to use the outermost component. So we're going to hit this little plus thing. It's going to allow us to add some different options. We're going to add all of the rotational axis. So if you go to the top thing there, you can then add all. So we're going to just click that, and it gives us these three things. In here, you can just change any of these to whatever you want. So I just did that there. There's some extra options in here if you click this little arrow on the side where you can set from a list and things like that, and that will add that option to your component options up here in the top right. So when you click that, if you had this enabled, you would see that option in there. So that's where that comes from. Add attribute here. So I'm going to do on click because we want the sketch link to do something when we click. And then for this, we're going to be using three random numbers. So what I'm going to do here is put in three custom identifiers and our custom name. So I'm going to put in a ran X and use the same sort of characteristics as up here. So do that again. Just come down, enter a custom name, ran Y. And that's just random. That's what I'm choosing this. And I'm making these up, so these could be anything you want. So we have these few things. So now what we want to do is we want to set ran rote X, rote Y, and rote Z to their respective random number. So I'm going to come up here, I'm going to double click, hit the equals, and then you can actually shift click on the text and it'll just bring that over. So it's saying that there's no number in here because we haven't generated our function yet. Okay. In our onClick, what we're going to do is say set. So that is saying set this parameter that I'm about to do to something. We're going to do a parentheses. The first part of set is what you want to set. So in here, I'm going to do in quotation marks, ran x. And then what we want, and for all these commands, you can find them on SketchUp. I'll link down in the description where you can find all of the descriptions of the commands. We're going to put in rand between here. So the first thing is the parameter, so ran x. The second thing is the number. So we're setting the number, but because we want this to be a random number, we're going to choose 1. Then you choose the range here. So ran between 0 and then comma, and then the second number, and then we have ran between. And then we need to do an extra parentheses here on the end because we need to close everything out. So we have set, we have parentheses here, then we have our stuff here, and then we just need to make sure we close that off here. So I'm going to hit enter. And that's just going to enable that. And we're just going to check and make sure this works so that when I click to activate, you can see down here that we get a new number in here. And if I click again, it'll generate a new number between 0 and 25. So you just do that. Now, that's only one parameter. We have three of these, but this code looks good. So I'm going to do Control A to just copy that or to select all, and then Control C to copy it. But I need to add a semicolon between my commands. So I just added a semicolon there. I'm going to hit Control V to paste. And then I just need to change my number here. So ran Y, I'm going to change to, or change ran X to ran Y there. Another semicolon, and then Control V to paste again. And then I'm going to change this to ran z. Now, in this particular case, I don't necessarily need just 25. The reason that I have chose 25 for the other two is that I want this coin to be kind of flat, that it can have a little bit of leeway in the x and y direction. But what I really want is just a little bit of variety for it to be mostly flat. That's why I chose from 0 to 25. The z-axis, it can be rotated in any direction. I'm using 360 because that's the degrees in a circle. It doesn't matter what that is. So that'll give me a little bit more variety in the z-direction. So that looks good. I'm going to hit enter on this, and it's just going to put that in. Now when I select this, you can see that it generates new numbers for all of these, and then puts that up here because these two things are linked. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.